Hey guys, it's Sarah from the Frugal Bear. So I was watching videos earlier today, and I was watching Molly from Molly's Artistry, and she was doing a wave. Now, I've always wanted to do a wave. I have yet to do one. This will be my first attempt. I've kind of shied away from it because there's swiping involved. And we all know how my swipes turn out. But watching Molly do it and the way that she did it gave me renewed hope. So if you want to watch a real pro do it, I will link Molly's channel down in the description. So we have our colors. We have our base is white. We are using dark blue with a hint of black in there to get it darker because I just didn't have a dark enough blue and I wanted something really, really dark. And each of my colors have just a couple drops of silicone. This is metallic blue by Artist Loft. This one is turquoise blue. By Liquitex. This one is powder blue, and that is also Artist Loft. And this one is metallic ice blue by Folk Art. And last but not least, we have this, I don't even know what it is, color. It's house paint. The mixture, it was something we had painted my daughter's room, this color, and it was two parts, so I didn't write it on there, two parts phthalo green to three parts phthalo blue or something like that. Anyways, so let's just get started here. We'll lay down our base of white. And now I've been getting a lot of requests to see the finished paintings. And obviously I'm not going to show them the dried paintings at the end of each video because we all know how long they take to dry. But I will be doing some dried ones in at the end of each video from previous pours. And then I'll also link that pour in the in the description card or whatever. So that way we can see the dried results before they're varnished. Okay, let's just torch this quick. Pop any air bubbles. Okay. Let's make sure we're fully in bright in there. Okay. All right. So let's just cross my fingers. So we're going to start here and we're going to go up and around. Help if I knew how to pour. Oh, well, this is not going to go well, is it? We'll see. I think my paint needs to be a little thinner. Not so gloppy. So maybe seems thin enough, but apparently it's not. We're just going to continue and roll with it, right? My husband, his paint studio is upstairs. He wants to try an experiment with me. He wants to do a double flip cup on a canvas, but he wants us to each make a cup with whatever colors that we choose and not tell the other person. So I will pour mine down here. He will make his up there. And then we will flip and see what we get. Sounds fun. I will probably sneak a camera up there so that we can record that. I think that would be interesting. So I don't know about this. I think this is just going to end up being a mess, don't you? It's not going to look anything like my pores were just too much, weren't they? Well, we're going to try it anyways. So, let's see, do I want this one? Or do I want the other one? Well, I just had the other one. I lost it. So, this one it is, right? And we're just going to. Swipe. I didn't pour off enough of my white base. So, yes, this is a drastic fail. Just going to scrape off a whole bunch of there. See what we can salvage here. Well, poo. You know what? I don't know that I actually hate this. It kind of reminds me of a sky up here. This would be crashing something or other, crashing waves. There's calmer waters here, and maybe land back there. I'm at a loss. Do I scrape it? Do I keep it? Because I'm not talented enough to actually do anything more with this. I don't have drawing abilities. Let's think on this a bit, shall we? We've been getting a lot of requests lately to not only see the finished product, but to actually see the paintings when they're dry. So I will start doing that with each video. There'll probably be two behind when you see the dried one, because I usually do two videos back to back, and of course they wouldn't be dry by then. This is one that I did the other day that unfortunately my camera did not record. The gremlins were at play that day, but this is a 12 by 16 and I did a 3-cup flip just using some leftover paints that I had. So they were completely different colors, but they were three different flip and drags. With the white negative background. That was a very little cup up there. This was our dipped 8x10. And I will link the video to this one up in the corner. So if you wish to see how this one was done, you can click on that link. Now with this one, we also did two tiles in the same dip. Here was one. And there is the other one. So two tiles came out of that dip from the 8x10. So there we go, those two tiles and this 8x10. Like I said, I will link that up in the corner for you to take a look at. Thanks.